Good morning and welcome to the opening ceremony of the Sri Lanka Medical and Equipment Virtual Expo 2021. I would like to welcome our chief guest, Dr. Rakesh Pandey. He's the First Secretary, Economic and Commercial Wing of the High Commission of India in Colombo. I would also like to give a warm welcome to Mr. Manjula De Silva, Secretary General and CEO of the Ceylon Chamber of Commerce, Mr. Gehan Seneviratne, Chairman of the PR Committee of the Sri Lanka Chamber of Medical Devices Industry, and Mr. Pankaj Verma, Additional Director and Head of International Trade Fairs, the Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce and Industry. I would like to request Mr. Rajesh Bhagat, the Managing Director of WorldX India, an organizer of this virtual expo, to give the welcome address. Mr. Bhagat.
Thank you, Mitra. So Dr. Rakesh Pandey, First Secretary, Economic and Commercial Wing, High Commission of India, Colombo. Mr. Manjula De Silva, Secretary General and CEO of the Ceylon Chamber of Commerce. Mr. Gehan Seneviratne, Chairman of the PR Committee of the Sri Lanka Chamber of Medical Devices Industry. Mr. Pankaj Verma, Additional Director and Head, International Trade Fairs, the Federation of Indian Chamber of Commerce and Industry, exhibitors, buyers, delegates, industry supporters, our partners, distinguished guests, and members of the press. Very good morning to all of you. It is with great pride that I welcome you to the opening ceremony of the Sri Lanka Medical Equipment Virtual Expo 2021. The terms health and medical have gained a whole new dimension in the world post-2020. The need to ramp up health and medical facilities cannot be overemphasized. Realizing the need for this increased regional cooperation to upgrade medical and health facilities and keeping in mind the travel restrictions, we decided to make the Sri Lanka Medical Equipment Virtual Expo 2021 on the B2B Asia platform. Through this B2B Asia platform, we have narrowed the gap between physical and virtual by organizing one-to-one business matching meetings. Whether it be video calling for face-to-face meetings.
Thank you. Okay.
Or dropping your business card, or taking a brochure from the booth, or even requesting for a quote or scheduling meetings at your own convenience. We have tried to ensure that this expo closely mirrors a physical show. I'm pleased to say that this distinctive platform has attracted some of the leading companies from India, China, Japan, Indonesia, and others to bring you the latest in medical technology, equipment, healthcare, imaging, diagnostic equipment, raw material supplies, as well as related technologies for the hospital, laboratory, and diagnostic centers, pharmaceutical, medical, and rehabilitation sectors. India is the partner country for this virtual exhibition, and FICCI, being India's apex chamber, has formed the India Pavilion with over 50 companies participating with medical textiles, face masks, hospital linen and disposables, medical devices, surgical tools and equipments, diagnostic supplies, and many more items. We are aware of the increased demand for medical and healthcare products in the region. According to the Central Bank, Sri Lanka imported around US$552 million worth of medical and pharma products in 2019. And around 80% of Sri Lanka's medical and pharma products are imported. At the same time, demand has increased with spending in private healthcare expected to touch US$2.4 billion by 2024. This platform will go a long way in bridging this demand and supply gap, while also ensuring that genuine business collaborations and ventures take place. This virtual expo is a great opportunity for the Sri Lankan healthcare industry to interact virtually with quality industry suppliers and access the benefits of a physical trade fair from the comfort of their own locations. With these few words, I would like to thank Dr. Pandey for taking time off from his busy schedule to inaugurate this international virtual trade show. And I thank all our supporting chambers and associations for their contribution in making this show successful. I would now like to thank the exhibitors and buyers. Great success at this virtual exhibition. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Bhagat, for that warm welcome. I now invite Mr. Manjula De Silva, Secretary General and CEO of the Ceylon Chamber of Commerce, to give the opening remarks. Mr. De Silva.
Good morning and a warm welcome to all of you to this Sri Lanka Medical and Equipment Virtual Expo, SLME-VE, which has been organized by Rolex India in partnership with the Ceylon Chamber of Commerce and also supported by the Sri Lanka Chamber of Medical Devices Industry, the Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce and Industry, the National Chamber of Commerce, and several other organizations, and also with the blessings of the Indian High Commission here in Colombo as well. And who was represented today by Dr. Rakesh Pandey, the first secretary of the Indian High Commission. So I'm very glad to be here representing the Ceylon Chamber at this very important event, which, as Mr. Bhagat mentioned, has been organized with the objective of bridging the gap that exists between the demand and supply of high quality medical and healthcare products in Sri Lanka. Given the constraints that we are facing today in organizing a physical event as we have been used to over the past, we have been able to organize this virtual platform, which is a method that we have very successfully used over the last 1 year in reaching out to both buyers and sellers across many different countries. And from the registrations that we have received, we are glad to note that this event will also be a major success in that sense. Since I'm told that we are going to have virtual face-to-face meetings showcasing over 50 brands and over 2,000 products. So that's something I think we can be very happy about, because it's going to cover a wide range of products. And I saw some of the brands, some major global brands and regional brands are among those that will be showcased within the next few days. Here I see that there are opportunities not only for trade, but also for business collaborations and joint ventures as well. So I really hope that the meetings that will take place will lead to some interesting new ventures also in the time to come. So I will not take a lot of time, because we have many more to speak today during the inauguration. So I would like to, in particular, thank Mr. Rajesh Bhagat, MD of Verdex, for inviting the Ceylon Chamber to be a partner in this very valuable initiative. And also thank Mr. Pankaj Varma from PIKI, with whom also we have been collaborating a lot on many forums and activities. Happy to see you here and happy to work with you again. And also wish to thank Dr. Rakesh Pandey, who has always been behind any initiative, I think, involving India and Sri Lanka, somewhere there in the picture. So we thank him for all your support and blessings as well. So on that note, I would conclude. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr.
De Silva. I now invite Mr. Gehan Seneviratne, Chairman of the PR Committee of the Sri Lanka Chamber of Medical Devices Industry, to give his opening remarks. Mr. Seneviratne.
Right. Thank you very much once again. Good morning to all of you. Let me take this opportunity to recognize the members of the Ceylon Chamber of Commerce, the members of the Sri Lanka Chamber of Medical Devices Industry, members of the Federation of Indian Chambers and of Commerce and Industry, the Indian High Commission, WorldX India, heads of PR committees, also the distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. So it gives me immense pleasure and honor to welcome you this morning on behalf of the Sri Lanka Chamber of Medical Devices. And we thank you so much for joining us live on this virtual platform today. In the long history of the world, we have seen many pandemics, and what we are going through now is very worse. The current time demands out-of-the-box thinking to solve the everlasting issues, and we are pleased to endorse this unique expo, which allows the Sri Lankan healthcare sector to access global suppliers on a single platform from the safety of their homes. As visioned, we sincerely hope that this platform would definitely bring a new sustainable business opportunity and a greater networking in the medical and healthcare industry, and an excellent opportunity for Sri Lankan medical and healthcare professionals, the importers, the manufacturers, the retail chains, and all others to access a large bank of globally renowned companies for Sri Lanka. At the same time, exposure to a better and more efficient technology is important for the industry as a whole to move forward, and this platform looks to provide the same. It is a great pleasure for us to send this message to us as a supporting industry partner on the occasion of the inauguration of the Sri Lanka Medical and Equipment Virtual Expo 2021. Also, with the increasing requirements for medical and healthcare suppliers, given the current and future situation, we express our sincere gratitude to WorldX India for partnering with us to make this event possible together with all who have joined today. So I invite and I thank each and every person who were here, especially the manufacturers, importers, and also the retailers. And thank you very much for joining with us, and wish you all the best for a successful event. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Neviratne, for your warm words. I now invite Mr. Pankaj Verma, the Additional Director and Head of International Trade of the Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce and Industry, to say a few words. Mr. Verma.
Thank you, Mr. Dave. Dr. Rakesh Pandey, First Secretary, Economic and Commercial High Commission of India, Colombo. Mr. Manjula De Silva, Secretary General and CEO, Ceylon Chamber of Commerce. Mr. Gehan Seniwarthane, Chairman, PR Committee, Sri Lanka Chamber of Medical Device Industry. Mr. Rajesh Bhagat, MD, WorldX. Viewers from India, Sri Lanka, and other part of the globe, good morning. Good morning. On behalf of Federation of Indian Chamber of Commerce and Industry, I would like to congratulate WorldX Exhibition and Promotion Private Limited for organizing the first ever Sri Lanka Medical Equipment Virtual 2021 at this crucial time when collaboration in the medical and healthcare sector for the health and safety of the common man is the way ahead for countries, people, trade, and commerce. FICCI and Ministry of Commerce, Government of India have taken the initiative to form the India Pavilion at the Sri Lanka Medical and Equipment Virtual Expo. We are confident that joint ventures, collaborations, and long-term business deals will take place, and FICCI is proud to bring high-quality medical equipment manufacturers from India to this virtual expo. We at FICCI are committed to support and help the business service providers, manufacturers to project their achievements, translate B2Bs into business, and promote exports during this stress time through the virtual exhibition and B2Bs. I'm proud to share that the South Asia desk of FICCI has also been actively engaged in Sri Lanka. Moreover, FICCI is the officially designated nodal chamber in India by Ministry of Commerce, Government of India, for India-Sri Lanka Free Trade Agreement. Besides the South Asia desk, FICCI also has proposed to hold the Business Secretariat of India-Sri Lanka CEOs Forum. FICCI is the nodal industry chamber leading private sector's initiatives and actively supporting the vision of Government of India in Sri Lanka. The South Asia desk of FICCI has spearheaded a host of capacity building and thought leadership initiatives, buyer seller meets, innovation fairs, and product shows in both the countries, with institutional partner, the Federation of Chamber of Commerce and Industry of Sri Lanka, FCCISL. We have also been working closely with the Indian High Commission in Colombo and have been receiving their valuable support and encouragement from them as well. I'm sure that this initiative of organizing the India Pavilion at this virtual expo will present lucrative opportunities for the growth and development of the healthcare sector in our respective countries. It gives me great pleasure to mention that more than 50 Indian companies from healthcare sector are participating in this expo. This clearly indicates the high level of enthusiasm of the Indian industry to expand their outreach to Sri Lanka and offer their services. I am hopeful that Sri Lanka government and healthcare industry would welcome Indian companies with open arms, resulting in fruitful business tie-ups. With these words, I would like to conclude my remarks and wish all the exhibitors and buyers best and hope the expo will be a great success. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Verma. It is my honor to now invite our chief guest, Dr. Rakesh Pandey, the first secretary of the Economic and Commercial Wing, High Commissioner of India in Colombo, to give the keynote address. Dr. Pandey.
Thank you. Thank you very much, and distinguished representatives from the Ceylon Chamber of Commerce, the FICCI, Sri Lanka Medical Devices Industry, and Worldex India. I'm very happy to be with all of you today. And as all of you know very well, I mean, pharmaceuticals and cooperation in the medical sector has been traditionally a very strong area of our bilateral ties. And Indian companies have been present in the Sri Lankan market. They have good, I mean, for a number of decades now, I think they have excellent relations with their local partners, and they have been playing a very important role in fulfilling the local requirements for in the medical sector. Now, this provides a very strong template. We already have a strong base. Now, we can, I mean, with events like this, especially when you can't travel, I mean, this is a very effective way of ensuring that this relationship or this collaboration between our, medical industries on both sides keeps going. So I would, of course, express my appreciation for the organizers, to FICCI, Ceylon Chamber, to Worldex India for putting together this event. And this, I think 53 Indian companies are being represented in the, is that correct?
Right, sir.
53. So, I mean, a very good number, and as Mr. Sanviratne pointed out, a good number of Sri Lankan companies are also participating. This is, in fact, a really good initiative. We hope that there will be very successful outcomes in the interaction today. And, I mean, the strength of the Indian medical manufacturing sector is well known. Our industry is known for delivering world-class products at a very affordable price. And the, another very important aspect that has emerged over the last year is that the incredible resilience of our supplies. I mean, during the pandemic, we not only catered to our own requirements, but were very sensitive and were able to meet, to fulfill the trust that our partners have in us. I mean, supplies from India went out to all over the world. Our supply chains remain strong. We fulfilled our commitments. You have seen with the vaccines, India has been making all efforts to share its manufacturing capabilities and vaccine manufacturing with people across the world. And even if you look at PPEs, I mean, within a space of months, we repurposed our manufacturing capabilities to perhaps become the second largest PPE manufacturer in the world. So the strengths of India in medical manufacturing are well known. They are there, and they are available today for collaboration with close friends and partners in Sri Lanka. And I really look forward to that. In general terms, speaking about overall trade between India and Sri Lanka, I think despite the challenges last year, we still were able to have a decent trade figure. There was some decline as compared to 2019. But our bilateral trade stood at about 3.6 billion for 2020, and which is a decline of about a billion from 2019. But I mean, that given what happened in the past year, I think this is still a good figure. So cooperation in medical manufacturing and medical devices sector is a very important part of our collaboration and is an important component of our overall bilateral trade. And I really look forward to our companies getting together. I mean, companies in India and Sri Lanka getting together, strengthening this partnership, building stronger bonds. Sri Lanka is also very interested in encouraging manufacturing within the country. I will encourage our companies to look at the various possibilities, including the manufacturing zones that will be set up by the government of Sri Lanka. And similarly, I will request Sri Lankan companies to look at utilizing the capabilities and partnerships with Indian companies in the medical sector. So Ceylon Chamber, FICCI, and other trade bodies have been extremely supportive. Secretary General De Silva has been always very supportive of all our efforts to promote trade between the two countries. I really look forward to the success of this event. The High Commission of India, as usual, we stand ready to support all efforts to boost bilateral trade and interaction. Please feel free to write to us, connect to us on any issue that might be required. And my best wishes for the success of this event. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Pandey, for your kind words. And I'm sure that going ahead, this virtual expo will lead to quite a lot of more interest and business in the coming weeks and months. Mr. Bhagat?
Right.
Invited to give the closing remark.
So, thank you all for your opening address and giving your blessings to this virtual expo. And I'm sure it will be very successful. I would like to thank our chief guest, Dr. Rakesh Pandey, First Secretary, Economic and Commercial Wing, High Commission of India, Colombo, for inaugurating and declaring this expo open. I would also like to thank Mr. Pankaj Verma from FICCI, Mr. Manjula De Silva from the Ceylon Chamber of Commerce, Mr. Gehan Seneviratne from the Sri Lanka Chamber of Medical Devices and Industry, the National Chamber of Commerce of Sri Lanka, and our industry partners from various countries for their support to this virtual expo. I'd also like to express my gratitude to our trade publication partners and members of the press for their support. I would like to wish all the exhibitors and buyers success at this fair. And with this, we mark the end of the opening ceremony. Thank you all for gracing the occasion and wish all of us all the best for this success of this show. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Bhagat.
Thank you.
Thank you.